and welcome to another episode of Cooking Matters live on Facebook. Thank you for joining me. Today we will be making a grilled fish with mango and coconut salad. Yum, sounds amazing. Let me go wash my hands so we can get started. Recipe includes different steps, so let's get started. Let's marinate our fish, because our fish is supposed to be marinated between 20 to 30 minutes. That's what we're going to do now, marinate our chicken, sorry, our fish. We're making fish. We're marinating our fish and then preparing everything else. Okay, so today I have fresh yellowtail. You can use any pound of firm white fish like mahi-mahi, pink snapper, cod. Today I brought yellowtail. Whatever fish you have available, make sure to take the skin. It's nice and rinsed and cleaned out. I rinsed it already and then pad dry so it can absorb the marinade. And the marinade's going to be simple. We're gonna add 2 tablespoons of coconut milk. If you don't have coconut milk, you can substitute with regular milk. It's only for flavor. If you don't have coconut milk, you can go ahead and use your favorite marinade, salt, garlic, pepper. And I'm putting enough so it's covering the fish. I'll show you in a minute. I'm gonna make sure it's fully coated. And since we're using more fish, I'm adding a little bit more. And the coconut milk is a little bit thick. And it's only for flavoring. And it smells like coconut. All right, so I put in coconut milk in here. Now let's go ahead and minced garlic cloves. The recipe calls for 2, I'm only gonna add, recipe calls for 3, I'm only gonna add 2. So what I like to do is grab a garlic clove with my knife, gently smash it, you'll crack it open, and the skin comes out super easy and fast. See? Go ahead and do the second one. Not covering your view. Putting it upside down. Light bump. And the skin is off. Like I said, the recipe calls for 3. I'm only using 2. I'm going to mince them and put them in my fish to marinate. And remember, this is for flavor. If you don't have garlic cloves, garlic powder also work. Remember, right now we're just marinating our fish. If you don't have coconut milk, you can use regular milk or not use it at all. And just add a little bit of olive oil. Just mincing my garlic as tiny as possible, because even though it's going to be marinating our fish when we cook it. Hi Larry, thank you for watching. I'm mincing the garlic and that's going to give our fish flavor. Alright, now the garlic is going inside with the fish. And remember, garlic is a bit sticky. So if you want to wash your hands after handling the garlic, please do so. And that's what I'm going to do. A little bit of soap. Garlic is in here. Now salt, pepper. I'm seasoning my fish. I think that's enough. Now, I'm gonna close my bag because we're gonna make sure our fish is fully coated in their marinade. I'm going to add a little bit more of seasoning. Just I want to make sure that both pieces of fish are well seasoned. Again, making sure we seal our bag. We don't want for a fish or a marinade to spill. So remember, fish is going to be marinated for 20 to 30 minutes or overnight. And this is how it looks with the coconut milk. A bit creamy. Again, if you don't have coconut milk, don't add it. And this is going to go back to the fridge until we're going to cook. Meanwhile, another thing that we're going to use in our salad is coconut, which is in the name. So let's go ahead and toast our garlic, coconut. So let's go ahead and get our heat going. And this is going to be for garnish. And it's going to be lightly toasted. I couldn't find unsweetened, so I got the sweetened one. And it's just a light toast. So we don't need it to be black, just maybe a little bit brown. Let me add a little bit more. This is the flavoring. It smells like coconut. Right. And it's toasting. You'll see it might shrink a little bit. And that's completely normal. That's what's happening here. And let's just keep moving it. My heat is medium high, so that's why I am keeping my eye on it. I'll show you in a minute. Only some flakes are going to turn light brown. Not all the flakes. And I'll put it in a glass container so you can see. Changing color to a little bit brown. And we're doing this at the beginning so it cools down. Garnish when we're serving our salad. Oh my goodness, this is perfect. All right. And it's warm, so be careful. Some brown, not all of it, some of it changed colors. That's what we're looking for. We don't want it burnt. Just a little bit toasted, caramelized. Now let me go ahead and clean the pan. It's ready for our fish. Let me add a little bit of olive oil so my fish doesn't stick. And cook our fish. Let's pretend it was marinating for 20-30 minutes. Remember, the longer it's marinated, the better taste is gonna have. Alright, so here's one. Here's two. Alright. Wash my hands. So our next step, while our fish is cooking, we are getting started on our dressing. If you have a favorite vinaigrette, go ahead and use it. Or an Italian dressing, something that has olive oil. If not, we can make our own too. And that's what we're doing today. So depending on how much salad, so we're just gonna make a general amount with olive oil. Lime juice. And honey. Oh, that fish is cooking. Really good. And if you want to add the red pepper flakes, I don't want to be spicy. And then you can just shake your dressing. This might take a little bit longer because my honey, I think it's too thick. Let's keep an eye on our fish. And let me go ahead and put in some seasoning. Want it too sweet. Actually, it does have some chili flakes in here. And I'm still mixing my vinaigrette. It still has honey in there. And I keep mixing. Remember, don't forget the fish. We need to flip it in a little bit. I want to be careful, I don't want the lid to come off. Remember, safety first. Almost there. Alright, so we have our fishing cooking, our vinaigrette almost done. Let's go ahead and get our mango ready. Also, don't forget to try your food. So let me go ahead and see the dressing. More honey and condiments too. And this is according to your liking, so make sure you're trying it, you're tasting it. If you need more salt, more pepper, if it needs to be more sweet, you can add more honey. And let's keep shaking it. Alright, fish looks like it's ready to flip. Right about time. Alright, wash my hands again. Now we're gonna get ready with the mango. So if you can't find the right mango, you can use, there's canned mango as well. I'm trying to peel it, let's see how that works. And again, this is for flavor. If you can't find the right mango, don't stress over it. And then we'll cut them into squares. They're going to go in our salad. And what I'm gonna do is try to scoop it out and keeping an eye on my fish. There's also a dried mango that you can use, or if you can't find mango, you can use the rest of other fruits. Don't be afraid, don't be shy to try other fruits that you wouldn't try in salads. There you go. And it looks like our fish is ready. Let's turn that off. Here. Our mango is ready. Let's get our greens. So you can use romaine lettuce, you can use mixed greens. Always, always wash them, even though they say they're washed, just to be safe. You don't want dirt or fine little critters in our food. So let's go ahead and wash it. And I'm using 50-50 spinach with spring mix. Make sure I'm rinsing it. The less water, the better. If your fish is too cold, that means it's ready for the salad. If it's too warm, then maybe we can serve it as a side. Let's see how the fish is doing. Let's go ahead and try to cut it in cubes as well. Let me wash my knife. And we're just gonna cut him and actually it's flaking off, so you don't need to cut it. Remember, it's going over your salad. So let's go ahead and start plating. We have our greens. Let's go ahead and grab our fish. We're just going to drizzle our fish over. I love mango. Can you tell? And let's go ahead and add a little bit of coconut. Oh, it's so crispy. Imagine when you take a bite. And let's not forget our homemade dressing. Grilled fish with mango and coconut salad. Another healthy recipe, a recipe with fish, something else we can cook. So remember, if you don't have coconut milk, you can always substitute for regular milk. If it's a non-dairy, then go ahead and just use, you can even use your vinaigrette and marinate your fish 20 minutes or more so it absorbs. Make sure it's clean, half dry, so it absorbs all the ingredients that you're marinating with. As you can tell, it didn't take that long to cook the fish, 3 to 5 minutes each side, and it got a little bit brown, as you can see. So you can cook it less time is better, but I like it the way it is. And then we put mango. Again, if you can't find mango, we can use pineapple, try other fruits that maybe you don't think it would go in the salad, but it can be a good addition to it. And pair it up with different kinds of fish too. All right, well, thank you for joining me today and in this recipe. Sorry, I'm still sticky with the mango. Join us next week, September 29th. We will be making a quick stir fry. So see you next week. Also, quick reminder, join us at 4. We have Richard DeCrane, a culture keeper for the Youth Center. He'll be going live at 4. So stay tuned. Thank you.